In this video, we'll explore some basics about camera rigs in Maya. As was covered in the previous video, Camera Navigation in Maya, the default cameras in Maya are similar to the Softimage viewpoint cameras. They're great for viewing the elements in your scene as you're working, but at some point you'll need to create a camera rig for animation and rendering. In Softimage, there's a default camera rig, and you can also create your own from the camera menu. In Maya, there is no default camera rig, so you can create your own from the Create Cameras menu. There are three basic camera variations, as well as a stereo camera and a multi-stereo rig. We won't cover the stereo cameras and rig in this video, but you should know that the stereo camera in Maya 2015 is essentially the same as it is in Softimage 2015. For information on using both the stereo camera and the multi-stereo camera rig in Maya, see Stephen Rosell's blog on the area. So, let's get back to creating some cameras. The camera command creates only that, a camera object that you can use for static scenes or with simple camera animations, such as panning or constraining it to an object on a motion path. The camera and aim is what the camera plus its interest is in Softimage. And this rig plus an up vector is called the camera aim and up. You can click the options box to set up the camera before you create it. Let's take a look at the camera rig in the outliner. You can see that the parts are children under a camera group, which is like the camera root in Softimage. There's the camera itself, its aim, or its interest, and its up vector. After you've created a camera, you can switch to it from the Panels menu in a viewport. To select the camera object itself, you can choose View Select Camera or click the Select Camera icon in the camera's title bar. You can set the camera attributes in the Attribute Editor, which you can easily access by clicking this icon in the title bar. You might want to start by giving your camera a name. Just to note that the blue cells for the rotate values indicate that the camera is constrained, in this case to the camera aim and the up vector. These attributes are standard camera things, such as angle of view, focal length, camera aperture, aspect ratio, depth of field, near and far clipping planes, and more. You can set up the default values for the near and far clipping planes in the Preferences window. As a convenience, you can change the type of controls for your camera rig here. For example, if you decide that you want to add an up vector or aim to a simple camera, you can do that here. And you can remove controls, as we'll do with the up vector, to make a simpler camera rig with just an aim. You can choose options from the View Camera Settings menu or click their icons in the title bar to customize what you see for the camera in a viewport. Note that these particular options apply to all viewports that show the same camera because they're actual camera attributes. They're not associated to the viewport itself like some of the other display options. You can display things like film gates and resolution gates, which we'll look at in a minute. You can also toggle a gate mask for either type of these gates. You can display the standard camera safe action and safe title areas, and a field chart for animation registration. You can also toggle these options and set them up in the camera's attributes. For example, you can set the gate mask color and its opacity here, similar to how you can with film gates in Softimage. Film gates indicate the viewing area for real-world cameras, but be aware that they're different from their counterpart in Softimage because they don't automatically represent the region that is rendered. To do that, you need to match the camera aspect ratio to that of the render region as set with the image size options in the Render Settings window. Resolution gates are closer to what film gates are in Softimage because they do mark out the actual rendering boundaries of the camera for a particular rendering resolution, as you can set here. Let's move on to camera animation. You can animate the position and rotation of cameras like any other object in Maya by setting keys via the channel box. If you want to animate the camera itself and not the whole rig, the camera group, make sure to first select only the camera object. Likewise, make sure to select only the aim object if you want to animate only its position. If you want to animate the camera's roll, you need to open the camera group's attributes and key the twist value. You can also find the camera's up vector attributes here and set up an aim constraint for the camera, which is the same as the direction constraint in Softimage. If you're using a camera with both an aim and an up vector, you can create a group containing only the camera and its up vector so that you can more easily animate these two as a unit without affecting the aim. You can edit the F-curves for the camera animation in the graph editor as you would for any other animated object. Another editing tool in Maya that's nice to use is the Editable Motion Trail, which can be used for any animated object, but is very handy to use with cameras and aims. Just select the key points on the trail and move them as you like to edit the camera's or aim's motion. For these and other tips about camera animation in Maya, see Daryl Obert's Maya Camera Tips and Tricks video on the Autodesk YouTube channel. In Softimage, you can constrain the camera interest to an animated object to follow it. In Maya, one way to do the same thing is by parent constraining the camera aim to an animated object, which is like a pose constraint in Softimage without scaling. In Softimage, you often animate the camera and/or its interests along a path. You can do the same thing in Maya, where path animation is called a motion path. You can parent constrain the camera group and/or its aim to objects, such as locators or nulls, that are attached to a motion path, then animate the camera's movement as you like. If you're working with multiple cameras, you can switch between them using the sequencer, which is like the camera sequencer features in the animation mixer in Softimage. To see how to use the sequencer, watch the video called Using the Maya Sequencer on the Maya Learning channel. If you want to be able to render from multiple cameras, open up the Render Settings window. Then scroll down and open the renderable camera list. Click Add Renderable Camera for each camera you want to add, and then select the camera you want. In the next video, we'll show how to create image planes in Maya to do rotoscoping.